suddenly hit me. And I remember I came home one day, I told my parents, I'm gonna be an artist, this is happening. I was 4 years old, at least maybe five. My uncle Vincenzo was a guest in our house, and he was a watercolorist, an artist himself. And I was completely mesmerized by the fact that this uncle of mine was applying this beautiful pigment on paper and creating some beautiful landscapes. At one point, he even asked me, "What do you want to paint with me?" So he gave me three colors and one little brush. And I recall very vividly today, applying myself, 5 years old, this pigment with water into the paper. That, I think, officially looks like it was my first introduction to art. Age 14, I was sick. I got a problem with my kidney, so I had to be in bed for 6 months. And I was completely depressed, and so my father, to cheer me up, he decided to buy me oil. And I never heard the oil before. It was a beautiful surprise. So my first paint in oil, I actually painted it in bed, reclining on my back, and I put a small canvas on my knees, you know, on my legs. The painting was about, it's still life. And it's amazing. It's a black, dark background, a lemon and a pear. And still today, after 50 years, half a century, I'm still painting still life, which has a dark background and fruit, you know, it's fascinating. From age 14 to 19, 5 years, I had tremendous progress in my work, and I find a gallery in Rome. Is that I'm selling my work, my paintings in the gallery in Rome, or outdoor shows, and suddenly it hit me. And I remember I came home one day, I told my parents, I'm gonna be an artist, this is happening. People like my work, and my parents completely flipped. Well, I know my destiny was signed right there, you know, that's the first time, by age 19. That again, it was another destiny for me. I was in Spain in 1972, and Salvador Dali saw photographs of my oil paintings and immediately wanted to meet me. And I was in Spain, so I was invited for a visit with Salvador Dali and Gala, his wife. And it was a fantastic experience. In fact, he asked me to come back again, and the second time, so even better, because he was working and we spent several hours together. And he gave me an amazing insight about art in general and about my technique and everything else. It was fantastic. I was in Rome painting and in the 70s, and I wanted to visit America, so I want to come visit California. So I decided to fly to LA just to see for the first time this country, and I landed in Los Angeles practically not knowing anybody. I had no idea that Los Angeles was so big, so I didn't have a car, so I started walking in Los Angeles. And I'm walking in Beverly Hills with pictures of my work with me because I want to go in gallery and show them to share. So I walked in this gallery 4 days, my first 4 days in this country, and the owner of the gallery liked my work so much that he offered me to do a show in 6 months. I was shocked, and of course I accepted it. And I came back 6 months later with my paintings, and we do the one-man show, my first 1973 in Beverly Hills. But then over the years, spending, you know, 35 years in California, I find out about Maui. Because you know, Maui has always been a great art market, and I was curious to see Hawaii, and so I came with a painting and I found a gallery, and they love my work. So now I'm with the same gallery after 22, 23 years, and so I decided, little by little, visiting Maui, I decided to move here, and moving Maui about 8 years ago, it really changed something about me, about colors and light. and I'm really happy at this point to live here, you know, because it's really beautiful, the environment and the spirituality of the island. It really feeds my soul. My experience meeting the Dalai Lama, it was phenomenal. In 2005, I was invited for a special private interview with the Dalai Lama in his house in India. It was part of a project, and I had to do a painting about him, and the project was called The Missing Piece. The moment of meeting him was incredible. I was very nervous, I had a butterfly in my stomach, yeah, because in my mind, I want to ask him if he could pose for me, because I had an idea for a painting, but I need him. So I brought with me my camera and all my equipment, and I thought, how is he going to be able to pose for me? What if he doesn't want to do that? Then I have to do another painting. But anyway, so he accepted it, and here I am photographing the Dalai Lama in his house, in his chair. After I left his house, I wasn't the same person, you know. It changed me profoundly, because what he does for these people and the world, it's very inspiring. And I saw things differently with my eyes when I came back to America again. And so today, I still have that. It was really amazing. Emotions are very important for an artist, and in my case, when I'm happy and things around me are doing well, I have a tendency to paint the best paintings. I need to create an environment around me that it's good, it's positive, my personal life and where I live, because then everything comes from there. It's beautiful, it's fantastic, it's powerful and creative. We'll be right back.